Teddy's got cash in his pocket, but he's not spending it on his pregnant girlfriend.
Megan's back at the room and just leave her there and come out and have a little phone, you know?
He's hooked up with another local Gorgia girl, Corrie. Right.
First thing you gotta do is grab the shaft. Do you see the tip?
Yeah.
Does it look nice?
And his pregnant girlfriend is soon forgotten.
I guess the girls like me. I'm not tooting my own horn, but toot, toot. You know what I'm saying? I'm a good-looking guy. I'm a sexually active person. I like for women to experience the Teddy experience.
Teddy Lee knows what he likes when it comes to women, and Corrie ticks many boxes.
Bought this new Gorgia Rackley down here. She's something fun. She's really spontaneous. She's beautiful. She looks good. I give it to her. Oh, baby, you missed a little bit, but that's good. She got beautiful feet. She got beautiful teeth. She used to be a dentist, so she keeps a beautiful mouth. Right. Make sure, you know, that's all you need in a woman. Beautiful teeth, beautiful looks, beautiful feet, and a banging body. She has a crazy crush on me. She loves the way I look, thinks I'm sexy. Step back a little bit. Oh, yeah, that's right. Bend down a little bit. A little bit farther. A little bit farther, yeah. I'll start throwing the moves on her, and then I know from there on out, it's downhill. She'll fall into the little groove. Like I gotta say, she's a good girl. Oh, yeah.
I'm out with another girl while I got Megan at home because I just want to have a good time. I'm a playboy, and she's pregnant. You know, you don't want to go out with somebody that can't drink while you're having a good time.
Two more fireballs.
Our relationship is just kind of like friends. I mean, friends with benefits, maybe friends, you know.
Getting it on tonight.
He's crazy. He's a troublemaker, but he is so cute, and he is so fun.
The difference between a Rumney Chill girl and a Gorgia girl, Rumney Chill girls, those are somebody you really just want to settle down with and make a life with. Gorgia girls, somebody just to have some fun with. You know, it's whatever. If, you know, if you want to drop me and go with him, that's cool, because I'll take your friend home with me, you know?
It's time to party, as only gypsies know how.
The Gorgia girls, when they see me in there, you know, a lot of them stare, and a lot of them know me. And if they don't know me, their friends know me. So I get a lot of action when I roll up in here. My dad always told me, you got to be like Tarzan. You can't let go of one vine till you got the other one. So like I say, I'm at least a two-woman man. I'm a 10-woman man.
Teddy may find it hard to stick to just one woman, but his first companion of the night is not letting him go without a fight, and she wants to sink her teeth into him, literally.
Help! Help!
In Coleman, Alabama, Romnichild Teddy Lee is playing a risky game. He's on his way home after a big night of booze and women. And he's got some explaining to do to his pregnant Gorgia girlfriend, Megan.
Here comes trouble.
Wild night. Did a lot of drinking.
I almost got molested.
Well, this girl kept biting me. Some chick, I don't even know her name.
Got her put out, man.
Yeah.
Man, was I not pushing them girls off? I was. I got her kicked out of the club. Look at my cheek. I woke up this morning, my face felt, feel it. It's like it's gonna be a big bruise. That was gonna be a lot worse than that.
It's not fair, but I mean, I still love him anyway.
She bought it. Probably not for long, though. It's probably just until the doors and the curtains get closed, and it's gonna be, what in the did you do?
And later that morning, Teddy is proved right. As he prepares for work, he gets the phone call he was expecting.
Hello?
It's Megan, and she's not happy.
Don't me today, for real. Nothing to do with
By
you.
Arguing with him, Megan is breaking a serious gypsy taboo, and Teddy is furious.
About me. Don't call my phone no more today, okay? Don't me no more.
She calls me in the morning time. We're arguing over the phone, and that's my number one rule over anything. Don't argue in the morning. That's a big superstition to me. That's a gypsy superstition. No arguing in the morning. If you see a snake crossing the road, turn around, go the other way. If you see a black cat, don't look and go the other way. If you hit a bird, that means death is coming. You know, crazy things, but to me, it's all true.
I'm telling you right now, don't call my phone no more. Don't me, don't my family, don't call my sisters, don't call nobody. It's over with, over and out, 1, 2, 3, bye. I got too much of my life going on to listen to from her.
Teddy's convinced that fighting with Megan is going to bring him bad luck.
I'm arguing with Megan, I'm on my way to work. I said, you know what, this day's gonna be bad.
And one way to distract himself from his girlfriend's curse is to hook up with Corey, the girl he met last night.
I need to get my mind off of it. I went and got Corey and went to work.
With Corey at his side, Teddy heads off to look for work.
You the owner here?
After trying a few houses in a new part of town, it soon becomes clear that the locals are suspicious of this gypsy worker.
We're out trying to get some work, me and Corey, and next thing you know, this guy just walks up out of his yard. We're sitting on the side of the road, and I'm kind of getting a little worried about him.
Hey, God bless you.
And then he picked up his phone and was looking at my tag and taking my tag down. And so we tried to get out of there as quick as we could.
Teddy's worried that they're going to call the police, or as gypsies call them, muskers.
Call them muskers, I think.
He believes the gypsy curse about arguing in the morning is coming true.
Really getting worried. I know, you know, now I know something is going on, so I tried to get out of there. Next thing you know, there's another man trying to take pictures of me.
Yeah, I pulled him.
Damn right you did.
My God.
Corey, you're gonna have to drive right now.
I ain't got license. I put Corey in the driver's seat.
Here.
Get us away from here.
I don't know if I can.
Just go. Oh man, I'm petrified of the muskers. Who ain't?
Where do you want me to go? Interstate or what?
Yeah, just get on the interstate.
Oh my God.
Roll that window up. She sped out of there, got us out of Dodge. Just bill.
Teddy may have got away this time, but he still believes his luck is turning bad.
Things are just not going the way they need to. You know, things are all messed up between my baby's mom. The work's not good. I just feel like this whole trip's jinxed.
Feeling superstitious, this gypsy boy decides it's time to leave town.
I miss you.
Miss you too.
And Corrie's not the only woman Teddy's saying goodbye to. He's also planning to break up with his pregnant girlfriend, Megan, and leave his unborn baby behind.
It's not my choice. I always get screwed, so that's cool. That's what you get when you settle with a gorger. That's the only penalty.
But breaking up isn't going to be easy.
I'm pulling up to Megan's house. She's got a nice house. You know, she lives a far-off life from mine. I was dropping her stuff off, trying to be nice, and she started getting hard-headed and running her mouth.
That's my fault.
Yeah, arguing with me. For real, it's bad luck. How many times do I tell you that a day? For real.
Megan still has more to say.
Who are you talking to?
It doesn't matter.
That does
no.
matter. Yes, it does.
Hell, hard-headed. That's why I can't stand a gorger ref. My dad told me a long time ago, my dad said, you will never in your life prosper with a gorger. You'll never have nothing. You will never in your life be able to have anything with a gorger. He said, son, you can make a gorger, act like a Romney Chell, live like a Romney Chell, talk like one, but there'll never be one.
As one relationship officially ends, the next one's already on Teddy's mind.
Oh, I guess I'm like Tarzan now. I done found me a good vine, so it's time to let go of this vine. It's rotten, so I'm gonna swing on this one for a little while till I find another one.
I'm just gonna roll on up a little north.
That's where the money's at anyway.
And whether there's money, there's honey.